हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव टू मूव फॉर द सेवेंथ सॉरी फिफ्थ सब क्वेश्चन इन द सेवेंथ वन. दिस इज़ द ट्राइंगल. वी वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट इन दैट द क्वेश्चन आई हैव ऑलरेडी गेव इन द यस्टरडे वीडियो ओनली. इफ ए कोऑर्डिनेट्स दे हैज गिवन एक्स वन वाई वन एंड द बी कोऑर्डिनेट्स आर एक्स टू वाई टू एंड द सी कोऑर्डिनेट्स आर एक्स थ्री वाई थ्री दे हैज गिवन. Okay, we want to find out the centroid of the triangle. Centroid in the sense midpoint of the triangle or midline of the triangle. Keep in mind, centroid in the sense median. It is also known as the median or the midline of a triangle. So let's find out first D for this median. Median is any one median we can find out. No worry about that. If we find out B, E, R, C, F, and AD, because three medians we can get exactly. So this D divides BC and E divides AC and in the same way F divides the AB. So we can calculate anyone. Okay, if we calculate anyone also, the answer is correct. So let's take first AD here. So AD, in that it is the AD is a median. If AD is a median, it exactly divides that BC. If AD is the median, if you have taken AD is the median, median in the sense or centroid is exactly divides D. I told you already, if median divides the line exactly, then there divides BC, then there is a coordinates are x1 plus x2, then the coordinates of D or you know the formula, x1 plus x2 divided by 2 plus x2 plus x3 y1 plus y2 divided by 2. So here x1 in the place x2 and x3 are there. That thing only we have to take, x2 plus x3 divided by 2, and here y2 plus y3 are there. That thing only we have to take, y2 plus y3 divided by 2. So you have to understand that if D divides the BC, if AD is the median, D divides the BC exactly, that's why the coordinates are x1 plus x2, that formula, divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2. But your coordinates we are using not x1, y1. So x2 plus x3 divided by 2, y2 plus y3 divided by 2. So this coordinates we got here, D coordinates, x2 plus x3 divided by 2 and y2 plus y3 divided by 2. These are the coordinates of D. Note down this. Okay, coordinates of what? D. So let's calculate the centroid. Centroid in the sense, I told you, median. The centroid, let the centroid GB. Centroid in the sense, we are taking here AD. We can also take CF or BF. Both are same, but here I am taking AD. So you can try with that also. So that AD in the sense, the distance between the A and D, they are divides. This has divides in the ratio 2:1, always it is. I mean median divides in the ratio, centroid of the median. This is firm for all, okay? Centroid of the median divides in the ratio 2:1. Always the centroid divides in the ratio 2:1. We can take m1 and m2 as a 2:1. Let's write given for this. m1 and m2 are 2 and 1. Then x1, y1 and x2, y2 we can take here. And x1, y1 are the this thing, AD, no, we are going to calculate. So this has taken x1, y1 itself, it is x1, y1 only. But x2, y2, we want to take the D coordinates. Keep that thing in mind, because we are going to calculate the AD or a centroid, right? Okay. So for that sake, so that is that formula, x2 plus x3 divided by 2 and y2 is y2 plus y3 divided by 2. So if the ratio has given, we know how to solve. GG is the centroid here. Keep in mind, better we have to, yes, okay. So how to solve? If the ratio has given, you know the formula to find the coordinates of G here. So that is m1 to find the coordinates of g here. I mean m1 x2 plus m2 x1 divided by m1 plus m2, then m1 y2 plus m2 y1 divided by m1 plus m2. Okay, so we can use instead of this m2 x1 plus m1 x2 in reverse also, no worry about that. So let us substitute the value for this. M1 is 2 into x2 is x2 plus x3, x2 plus x3 divided by 2, x2 value it is, plus m2 is 1 into x1 value itself it is x1 divided by m1 plus m2 in the sense 2 plus 1. Okay, so comma another coordinate, that is m1 is again 2 into y2 value is your y2 plus y3 divided by 2 plus m2 is 1 into y1 only itself it is divided by again the m1 plus m2 means 2 plus 1 3. Okay, so if you are here 2 get cancelled, even here also 2 get cancelled, remaining is your x2 plus x3 plus 1 into x1 itself it is x1 divided by 2 plus 1 in the sense 3, and here already 2 get cancelled, the remaining y2 plus y3 plus 1 into y1 is y1, so 2 plus 1 is 3. It's not in our order, we have to write this in order. So the centroid G is, okay, we can write as, if you are writing in order, x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3 and y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3. Okay, so this is the centroid of the coordinates G. Okay, in the same way, if you are calculating a CF also, we will get the same answer. If you are calculating the BE also, we will get the same answer. The centroid value will never change. The always it is constant. Centroid value is x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3 and y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3. We can use this formula to find out the centroid also. If they are giving a, instead of x1, y1, if they are giving a value, we can use this formula also, and this is also called as a one derivation of centroid. Keep in mind, it is also called as a derivation of the centroid. Just if they are asking in examination, derive the formula for centroid, so you can, up to this you can use. Okay, hope you will understand this. Let's move for the next one, 8th one it is. Let's read the sum. ABCD is a rectangle. So this, take a rough diagram. ABCD, it is a rectangle. This is a rectangle with a name ABCD. Okay, it is formed by the points A coordinates are -1, -1 and B coordinates are -1, -4. Then C coordinates they have given, that is the 5, 4, and the D coordinates is 5, -1. So these are the coordinates of ABCD. Then also they are giving PQRS are the midpoints of, P is the midpoints of AB, okay, respectively that is, and Q is the midpoint of BC. We want to mention like that only, okay, because particularly they are giving. And the R is the midpoint of CD, okay, then S is the midpoint of AD, okay, or DA they has given. Is the quadrilateral PQRS is a square. If we join this PQRS, this one more quadrilateral we get, quadrilateral in the sense having a four sides, okay, one more quadrilateral we get. So we want to find out this PQRS is a square or a rectangle or a rhombus. Okay, so we know that if all the sides are equal, that is a square or rhombus, because square properties and the rhombus properties are same. If the two sides are equal, that is a rectangle. Okay, let's identify, may it is a square or what rhombus or rectangle. So here P is the midpoints of AB. They only has given midpoint in the sense exactly divide. Then the coordinates formula we know that x1 plus x2 divided by P. So like that. So we can write. So let the coordinates of P are the coordinates of P or let's find the coordinates of P, the formula in on a line, on which line? AB. That thing also we have to mention, otherwise you will get confusion. On a line AB it is, P is the coordinates, P is the midpoint. Then we are going to find out the coordinates of P on the line AB. That's formula we know, that is the x1 plus x2 divided by 2 and y1 plus y2 divided by 2. So in this line, if you are substituting the x1 and y1, x1 is minus 1 and y1 is also minus 1 divided by 2, and y1 is again minus 1, then y2 is 4 plus 4 divided by 2. The coordinates we will get minus 1 in the sense minus 2 divided by 2, 4 minus 1 is 3, 3 divided by 2. So this will be cancelled. So we will get the coordinates, that is the minus 1, 3 divided by 2. So we can write here the P coordinates are minus 1, 3 divided by 2. Okay, in the same way we have to calculate the Q coordinates. The coordinates of Q are on the line, on which line? I think you know about it, is on BC. On the line BC, the same formula we can use. So here one time I am using, I'll write directly the answer. X1 is minus 1 plus X2 is 5 divided by 4 and Y1 is 4 plus Y2 is 4 divided by 2. So that equal to plus 5 minus 1 is 4 divided by 2 equals 4 plus 4 is 8 divided by 2. So 2 2's are 2 4's are the coordinates we will get 2, 4. So here we can substitute 2, 4 are the coordinates of Q. In the same way, coordinates of R on the line which line it is? DC. On the line DC, so if you have taken this, x1 plus x2 is here minus, 5 it is, 5 plus 5 is 10, we can write 5 plus 5 divided by 2, and y1 plus y2 in the sense 4 minus 1 divided by 2. So 5 plus 5 is 10 divided by 2, 4 minus 1 is 3 divided by 2, 2 5's are it is. So the coordinates we will get 5, 3 divided by 2. So here our coordinates are 5, 3 divided by 2. Let's find out the last one, coordinates of S. The coordinates of S or on the line, on which line? You can note down there, that is AD. So by using the same formula we can get x1 plus x2 in the sense minus 1 plus 5 divided by 2 and y1 plus y2 in the sense minus 1 divided by 2. So minus 5 plus 1 is 4 divided by 2 and minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2 divided by 2. 2 1's are, 2 2's are, 2 1's are, minus 1 it is. So answer finally we got here, 2, -1 are the coordinates of S, which are those 2, -1. Okay. Yes, now we have to find out the distance between P PQ by using the distance formula. PQ equals distance formula, you know already, square root of x2 minus x1, once I'll write, remaining you have to note down, x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. PQ in the sense, you know that P and Q coordinates we want to take. P coordinates are minus 1, 3 by 2. So, given here we can write x1, y1, x2, y2. Okay. X1, y1 is P coordinates minus 1, 3 divided by 2. What we got. And x2, y2 are the Q coordinates, that is 2, 4. 2 and 4. Okay, so if we are substituting the same here, PQ is x2 is 2 minus x1 is minus of minus 1 whole square, square root of, plus y2 is 4 and y1 is minus 3 by 2 whole square. So that equal to square root of 2 plus 1, it will become minus into minus plus 1 whole square, plus if you have taken a LCM here 2, so we will get 2 4s are 8, 8 minus 3 whole square, so nothing but it is 2 plus 1 in the sense 3 square, 3 square means 3 3s are 9 plus 8 minus 3 is 5 divided by 2 whole square, so that equal to the 9 plus 5 square in the sense it should be 25 divided by 2 square in the sense 4. So if you are taken a LCM 4 here in the down, so 25 9 4s are 36, it will become plus 25, so that equal to the square root of 36 plus 25 is 61 divided by 4. This is the value of PQ, keep in mind. So in the same way we have to find out the PQ after QR and RS, then SP. In the same way, let's calculate by using the same formula, that is the PQ after what, QR. In a order we have to come QR or RQ anyhow, so that is square root of same formula we can use, but write the given x1 y1 x2 y2. Q and R coordinates only want to take, the Q or coordinates are 2 comma 4 and the R coordinates are 5 3 divided by 2. Let us substitute for this, x2 minus x1 in the sense 5 minus 2 whole square plus y2 minus y1 in the sense 3 by 2 minus 4 whole square. So that equal to the square root of 5 minus 2 whole square means 3 square, plus if you have taken a 2 here, LCM 3 minus 2 4s are 8, 3 minus 8 whole square. So that equal to the 3 3s are 9 plus 3 minus 8 in the sense again here minus 5 divided by 2 whole square. Okay, so we will get almost in the same answer what we got in the previous, 9 plus 5 minus 5 square in the sense nothing but it is 25 only, plus 25 minus 5 into minus 5 it will become a plus 25, 2 square means 2 2s are 4. So again 9 plus 25 by 4 we will get the square root of 61 by 4. This is the answer of QR. So 2 we got, remaining 2 we have to check, RS. RS, the same formula we can use. Let's write the given for RS. This is a RS, x1, y1 and x2, x2, y2. Here no place, that's why I'm writing it for the side. So let's write R coordinates first. R coordinates are 5, 3 by 2 and S coordinates are 2, minus 1. Right, so 2 minus 1, let's substitute the same, x2 means 2 minus x1 is minus 5 whole square plus y2 means minus 1 and y1 means minus 3 by 2 whole square. So that equal to the 2 minus 5 whole square, in the sense minus 3 whole square, plus if you have taken a 2 LCM here, 2 into 1, 2 minus 2 minus 3 whole square. So that equal to the minus 3 square means 9, plus it is minus 2 minus 3 is minus 5 divided by 2 whole square. Again, almost we got the same 9 plus minus 5 square, in the sense 25 divided by 2 to the 4. So this is also we got the square root of 61 by 4. Last one thing is there, if you check that, we will get the almost the same answer. Here no place, so that's why I'm doing in a margin. You have to note down that. So that is PQRS after, sorry, last one, PS it is there. So PS equal to square root of same. Let's write the PS coordinates here. I mean x1, y1 and x2, y2. So the P coordinates are minus 1 y1 is 3 by 2. Then minus 1, 3 by 2. S coordinates are 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1, x coordinate, s coordinates they are. So if you are going to substitute for the same formula, x2 minus x1 in the sense 2x2 minus x1 in the sense minus of minus 1 whole square plus y2 minus y1. y2 minus y1 in the sense y2 is minus 1 and y1 is 3 by 2. So that is minus 3 by 2 whole square. So that equal to the square root of 2 plus 1, minus into minus plus 1. 2 plus 1 means 3 square plus. So if you have taken a 2 LCM here, 2 into 1 minus 2 minus 3 whole square. So that equal to the PS. So square root of 3 square means 9 plus minus 2 minus 3, again it will become minus 5, 2 whole square. So that equal to the 9 plus 5 is 25 divided by 4. Almost we got the same here also. Here also we will get square root of 61 divided by 4. So in all, I mean PQ equal to QR equal to RS equal to SP. So therefore here what we can write, PQ equal to QR equal to RS equal to SP. Therefore it is a square or also a rhombus, not rectangle. Okay, this tagline you have to write down. Hope you will understand. Okay, PQ equal to QR equal to RS equal to SP. Therefore, it is a square or rhombus. Hope you will understand. Thank you.